Hey guys, check it out. Today I'm reviewing the Banana Pi B-Pi M2. You may have seen my recent review for the Banana Pi M1 Plus, which is a pretty cool device. This is my unboxing of the Banana Pi M2. I haven't ever opened this box before, so as you'll see. There you go. Nothing else inside that box. It's just the M2. All right. As you can see, I'm opening this for the first time, so please forgive my lack of knowledge about this device. All right, well, just a little quick scan here. You can see that there's a bit of a difference in configuration between this and the M1 Plus, or even between this and the Raspberry Pi devices. It has two sets of USBs, but they're not lined up side by side. They're in a bit of an unusual configuration there. Let's just have a quick look at the backside to see about the soldering. Again, if you've watched my M1 Plus, you'll notice that I noticed a bit of inconsistent soldering on the GPIOs, and much the same with this one. Let's see if I can hold it up to screen here, get it to focus in. You can see some of those GPIOs are slightly darker than other ones. They don't seem evenly soldered across the board, which is a bit unusual and something I noticed in the other one as well. But as you can see, it's got a QC passed, quality control passed sticker on it, so I'm sure that everything works fine. All right, let me just put this down and let's do a quick walk around this board and see what interesting things we can find.
Actually, I'm going to flip this over. It's curling around a little bit. That'll make it easier to see.
All right, well, first things first, this is pretty unusual. Unlike the micro USB connectors that we've seen in the past, this one actually has a, can you see that? That's like a round connector. So this will need an external power supply, 5 volt, with one of these ends on it. Again, that's surprising and unusual. I might have to contact Banana Pi about that. I didn't see that coming, and certainly there's no charger in the box that comes with it, so this one might be a little more difficult to find a power supply for. All right, let's continue around the corner here. So there's the power supply. This is the HDMI, of course. This is the microphone and the LVDS display connector. This is called a boot button. And here is the debug TTL UART. And the reason that I buy a lot of these Banana Pis, this is the gigabit Ethernet, which is a major upgrade over the Raspberry Pi, and definitely a reason to consider these Banana Pi boards. Here you have USB, two USB connectors, and another two USB connectors just around the corner. As I've mentioned in previous videos, these all-winter chips, ARM chips, only go up to USB 2. You can't get USB 3 on them yet. In the corner there, you're going to see the IR. This is the earphone. This doesn't have an AV jack on it, so there's no yellow output from that. Here's your 40-pin header, so you can connect your GPIO to different things. This is a power and reset button. They've combined the two buttons into one on this board, and this is your USB OTG for connecting this device as though it was a peripheral. Of course, the chip on here, this is an A31S. This is a 1 GHz quad-core processor, so some serious kick-ass power in there. And you have your 1 GB of RAM on top. Oh, I almost forgot to mention, this is your camera interface here. If you have a camera for your Banana Pis, that's awesome. And just while I'm here to mention it, this is, I mentioned it before, this is your display interface. This is so you can connect a small monitor to your directly to your board. And what's amazing is Banana Pi's already made those, and Raspberry Pi is still definitely lagging behind. All right, let's flip the board over and have a quick look at the underside of it. This is your Wi-Fi here. This, of course, is your micro SD adapter, and there's your little Wi-Fi antenna, so you can increase your Wi-Fi range with that. But as I said, it doesn't actually, you don't get an antenna in the box, so I'll have to search for one of those. Besides that, that's pretty much all there is to say about this one. This has the four screw holes as well. They're not exactly in the corners, but they're pretty close. This, of course, will not fit in any case designed for anything else. It's not compatible with your Raspberry Pi cases, nor is it compatible with other Banana Pi cases because of the unusual configuration. So a couple of quick things that I've already noticed. There's no AV jack. There's no visual jack out except your HDMI connector. That means that if you have an old style TV, not that anybody does anymore, but it certainly means that this board will not be compatible with it. So that is something to take note of. And the other thing I'm still coming to terms with this is this power connector. This power connector is going to make it, you know, more challenging to find something that has a 5-volt that looks like that that's going to fit. Now, what I'll try to do is try to find one of those and put it in the About section below so that you guys have a direct link to it. But it definitely changes the nature of this type of Banana Pi board. It's certainly not like the Raspberry Pis all of a sudden, unless you can power it through this USB OTG, which I don't think you can. Again, I still love the Banana Pi boards. I think that they're fantastic, and they're definitely a reach ahead of the Raspberry Pis, if only because of the gigabit Ethernet. So a board like this could easily become a much improved home server or anything that relies on that faster connection, like a Plex server or something. And with this really fast processor, and I will in an upcoming video show you this booting up and what it runs like, how the desktop interface works and all that. But just thought I'd give you a quick unboxing and run around the outside. If you enjoyed this video in particular, you can of course buy me a coffee in the About section below. Don't forget to subscribe, and any comments or questions, please put in the comment section below. Don't forget to check out my other Banana Pi videos. I have lots of other cool things I've done with Banana Pis, and of course with Raspberry Pis, which this will be compatible with. If you have any questions, post them in the comment section below, and remember, if we do this as a community, we can help each other. You know, I'm not the only one who has one of these Banana Pis, and if you have one and you're hanging around, please do let us know and answer any questions that might be outstanding in the comment section below. I'm pretty excited to get this one plugged in, although I'm going to have to go find that power source in order to get it done. Don't forget to check out my Banana Pi M1 Plus review, which I've also done recently. And there's an upcoming comparison video, so if that's out by the time you're watching this, that link will be on screen now too. Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to give me a like if you like the video, a dislike if you dislike the video, and a high five if you see me on the streets. Thanks very much. Cheers, guys. Bye-bye.